Planet Rock. So day two of Planet Rockstock comes to a close with the amazing British Lion featuring this guy, a very good friend of ours, Steve Harris. How are you, mate?
Yeah, brilliant, mate. Yeah, I really enjoyed it. I loved it, actually. It was a lot of fun.
Great crowd out there.
Yeah, they're all, you know, I mean, a lot of people sort of probably didn't know a lot of our stuff, but they were really smart, you know, a lot of smiling faces out there, and, you know, I loved it. I really enjoyed it. It's just what it's all about, being close to the people, and it's just brilliant.
And as the set went on, they got more and more into it, because like you say, they probably didn't know all the songs. They know a few that we play.
I think there was people that didn't know any of the songs, but, it, you know, that's all right. That's cool, because, you know, they seem to, you know, get into it, and especially towards the end, and so, I think we got them in the end. We worked hard, and we do every night, but a gig like that, where it's not really our audience, most of them are not our audience, you know, you have to work just that bit harder, and... You know, we did work our socks off. If you can see, I'm soaking wet here. So we did actually work hard. And I think, you know, if we didn't get some of them, then so be it. But, you know, I think most of them seem to like it.
It's been 2012 since the debut album came out. But, of course, you've got your day job, which kind of gets in the way of doing the British Lion thing. But I think it's something like 14 months before this tour that you've actually played with the guys together.
That's right, yeah. It's been, I mean, just time flies when you're enjoying yourself, doesn't it? You know, with a day job. But, I mean, I'll be back out with that in, you know, April next year. So I'm looking forward to that. Life's good at the moment. I'm just loving it.
Now, a few weeks ago, you sent me an exclusive track that you recorded live on tour, because you've been recording all the shows. Yeah. Eyes of the Young, which you've just finished a set with literally seconds ago. Yeah. And I guess there's a live album somewhere in the pipeline.
Yeah, it'll be out hopefully. It will be out at some point next year, and then we'll do a second studio album as well. And so, we've made in and everything else. I mean, it's going to be a pretty busy year for me, but you know, I just love every minute of it, really.
As far as the new stuff is concerned, I mean, you've been talking recently in the press about a heavier direction. Is that something that it's developed as far as the band are concerned since you started? Because again, when you're working together and you're doing the live stuff, I guess you're kind of learning what each other can do.
Yeah, I think it's got more powerful as we've gone on, and it's just got, you know, sort of every and every, really. Maybe we're just hitting the strings harder, I don't know, but, you know, it feels like it is. And, it's just evolving in a natural way, so that seems to be the way it's going. It's got loads of melody, obviously, but, you know, I don't think there's too many bands out there at the moment playing with loads of melody, kind of more classic type of rock, but sort of every, you know, I don't know, really. Maybe I'm wrong, but... I'm not keeping up with it. What's going on, perhaps? I don't know, but someone tell me different. But that's what I think. So, you know.
So how many songs have you got written for a new album?
We've probably got, about eight or something like that. Well, and then there's two or three others that we've got to sort of finish off bits on them. And then, you know, we're pretty well there. So, it's not too much to do. So.
Now, it's been a massive tour. I mean, when you go out with British Lion, you try and get in as many territories as you can. You started off in your old stomping ground in Portugal as well.
Yeah, it was great rehearsing down there, and then playing the Motorbike Club, where we know good mates down there. So that was good as well, and we just sort of worked our way up through Europe and Poland and all that, and a lot of countries we never played before actually. So that was good, and obviously, you know, ended up over here, and then the last shows are in Ireland, and the last show in Northern Ireland in Belfast, so which we've never played Dublin, Limerick, or Belfast before, so. That's all good as well.
So literally three shows to go. I mean, you literally go from here straight onto a ferry, just like the old school days.
That's
back to those venues. And as you say, it's so nice getting up close and personal with the fans again, because when you're playing arenas and you're playing the massive stadiums that you played with Maiden over the years, to actually do this and to see people's faces at the front again must be great. I mean, you've been doing it a long time, but you still love it.
It's really enjoyable. You know, I mean, the bus is great, apart from all the snoring. When the bus stops, I can't deal with that, I've got to say. But that's the only downside, really. I do like being on the bus and you know, meet and greets with the fans and stuff. You know, it's been a lot of fun, and it's just nice to see people so happy when they have a photo with you and stuff like that. And so, yeah, it's nice. I can't do that with Maiden, really. It's just too many, and we tend to sort of go straight off the back of the gig and fly to the next place anyway. So, there's not really too much of that. But with this, it's a bit different. I mean, tonight we can't do too much of it, because we've got a ferry to get on. And if we don't make that ferry, there won't be a gig tomorrow. So, but other than that, normally we just do signings and stuff. And usually we're playing to less people. You know, it's like, you know, 300-400 people. So you can kind of, it's not so bad as 1 or 2 hour signing. If I did it tonight, I think I'll be here till tomorrow morning. So, well, maybe not. Maybe it'll all bugger off. But, you know, yeah. So, you know, it's good. It's nice.
great to see your boy George going down well this afternoon as well with the Raven Age. I mean, they are just getting better and better all the time.
Yeah, I mean, it's the first gig they've done actually as well since August, since they toured with Maiden. So, you know, they're probably a bit, you know, they felt they were a little rusty. But yeah, I thought it was really good, and they got a really good reaction, which again was great because, again, it's not their type of audience necessarily, you know. And so, yeah, all good all round, really. And the only bad thing was that West Ham, I didn't mention it, but West Ham got a drub in. I watched the first half, and then my son was on. That's love for you. I went and watched him instead of watching West Ham, but I suppose someone upstairs must have known something, because they lost it big time in the second half. So what can you do? I'm gutted with that, but I'm happy with a gig, so you can't have it always, can you?
And to add insult to injury, of course, there was the fact that Spurs, I think, won 5-0.
I don't want to talk about them.
All right, okay.
Don't talk about them at all.
All right, but listen, as always, great pleasure catching up. Well done with a cracking show tonight. Enjoy the last three dates. We'll look forward to the live album, the new studio album, and then, of course, the day job continues mid-next year.
It does, yeah.
Enjoy.
Yeah, cheers, we'll do.
Cheers, Steve.
Cheers, mate.
Steve Harris from British Lion, who've just rounded off another cracking day here at Planet Rockstock 2016. We'll catch you later.